Hello, and welcome to the first video in the BREEZE Incident Analyst product tour series. During this video, we will show you the user-friendly and intuitive features of BREEZE Incident Analyst, how to streamline your model setup using the Incident tab, and how you can easily get access to help at any point during your model setup. The interface of BREEZE Incident Analyst is designed similar to Microsoft product interfaces. Each tab contains options and features specific to that tab. The Incident tab is the heart of the program. Through this one tab, the user can specify all of the critical information needed for a model run. Additionally, the incident window contains three primary components that enable users to quickly view information regarding the scenario. These components are the scenario settings display, which contains tabs that provide access to the most commonly modified scenario options, such as chemical information, meteorological data, and result options. The scenario summary display, which provides an at-a-glance overview of the settings of the current scenario. And the potential problems display, which contains informational messages, warnings, and errors alerting the user to potential problems before the scenario is run. In BREEZE Incident Analyst, help is only a click away. You may easily access the user guide no matter what window you are working in. You will also find access to the help topics in the Home tab. The new start page design for Incident Analyst gives you more flexibility and guidance by providing you with a wealth of resources and an easy-to-find layout. In the User Guide tab, you may select an option from the different sections available to go to a specific part of the BREEZE User Guide. Also, you can find release notes, tutorials, and detailed technical documentation for all of the models included in the BREEZE Incident Analyst program. The user-friendly design and intuitive features of BREEZE Incident Analyst simplifies accidental release modeling. We encourage you to continue on to watching the other videos in this Getting Started series to best understand the model setup process, as well as the resources and features that are available to you. Learn how to add your chemicals and chemical mixtures to your model scenario in the next video.